this Kansas City. Shits ran gritty. In the summertime, the chicks be damn pretty. Born in the projects, then to the Ville. Hey, you guys, it's me, Bossy. Welcome back to my channel. Y'all, I'm so irritated right now because I had filmed this video already yesterday and I have to redo it because, one, my wig was not right, and two, I was out of focus. Some of my videos, though, I'm still putting up because, like, I had to do a snack tasting box. I can't redo that one, so that one's going up. So y'all might see my wig slipping. My lash was messed up. I wasn't that clear and focused. I just guess it was a rough night last night. And then my Q&A video, it was the same situation. So y'all don't come for me when y'all watch those videos. But anyway, today's video is going to be a story time video. And this video is about the time that I thought I was slick and went and got my first tattoo behind my father's back and then got busted from one of my snitch ass cousins. So this story isn't going to be very long, but let's just go ahead and get into it. So this happened in the year 2003. That was the year that I graduated from high school, and we had senior skip day. Now at our senior skip day, we went to, I think it was Lewis Park. It's a park off of like 70 something in Warnell. Is that Warnell? I think it is. Anyway, so that's where we had our senior skip day. So a couple of my friends, while we up there, you know, chilling and dancing and eating and, you know, just enjoying ourselves, one of my good friends suggested that we go and get tattoos. And I'm like, okay, I'm down, knowing dang well I don't have no business going to get any type of tattoo. So I think it was myself, my friend Gina, and Gina, I review her makeup brushes. She is the owner of the Pretty Bar LLC. So hey, Gina, if you're watching this. But it was myself, Gina, Tierra, and I think it was somebody else, but I just can't remember who else it was. But anyway, they were like, yeah, let's go get a tattoo. So they trying to debate on where we were going to go. And so then we just all came to the conclusion we were going to go to a tattoo parlor that was really close to where the park was. So it was called Arizumi, and it was also on Warnell, like I think 70 something, maybe 80 something in Warnell. So that's where we went. So, you know, the whole time I'm like, okay, I'm down. And so we get into the tattoo shop or whatever. And once I get in there, my nerves kick in. I'm like terrified. I'm thinking about my daddy. But at the same time, I'm like, forget this. I'm 18. I was 17 or almost 18. I can't really remember. I know it was before I was pregnant. And I was like, forget this. I'm getting me a tattoo. I'm getting me a tattoo. So I think I was second to the last to go. And everybody got like little regular size tattoos. Nothing too big or anything like that. So then it was my turn, and I was cool. I was a little nervous, but I'm like, this place is clean. You know, everything looks, you know, sanitized. I wasn't worried about getting no type of disease. Of course, I had to fill out the form, and they asked this, this, and that. I sat in the chair, and I proceeded to get my tattoo. Now, my tattoo I got, because y'all got a quite a bit, and my tattoo I got was this one right here. It says Bossy. And it is a little small for my arm because my arm has gotten bigger. My arm was a lot smaller when I got this. So that was the tattoo I got. And so I was like, okay, cool. So everybody got their tattoos. We went back up to the park. You know, we was trying to show everybody, even though we were supposed to have them covered up and stuff so they could start the healing process. We just showing everybody and, you know, just continued having fun. So, of course, you know, I ended up going home afterwards. I made sure I kept on my jacket until it was time for me to take my ass a shower and go to bed. So I think about 2 weeks had maybe passed. You know, it was still going through the healing process or whatever. And my dad still didn't know because, you know, I covered it up, you know, with long sleeve shirts or a short sleeve that covered up the tattoo or wore my jean jacket around them. So anyway, one day after school, I went over to my grandmother's house and a bunch of my cousins was over there. And one of my cousins that I could not stand, he was over there or whatever. And as soon as I walked in, the first thing he said was, "Ooh, Bossy, I heard you got a tattoo. I bet Preacher Roe don't know." And Preacher Row is what they called my daddy. That was his nickname. And I was like, what are you talking about? I was like, shut up, I ain't got no dang tattoo. He was like, nah, I heard you got a tattoo on senior skip day. And I'm like, I don't know what you're talking about. I ain't got no tattoo. Shut the hell up. You know, he was getting on my nerves. So then I thought, you know, the conversation was over. It was dead. And next thing you know, out of the blue, he came and like bum rushed me and like took my shirt and raised my sleeve up and was like, oh yeah, what's that say? Basic? What kind of tattoo is that? But I was like, anyway, it don't say basic. It says bossy. Get off of me. I was so pissed. And he was like, I bet Preacher Row don't know. I bet your daddy don't know you went and got this tattoo. And I'm like, whatever, shut up. And I'm thinking, I guess somebody he knows that was at the senior skip day that went to my school must have been like, oh, your cousin got a tattoo, and yeah, and must have told him. And anyway, I figured, all right, he ain't gonna snitch because I had dirt on him, so I know he ain't gonna snitch on me. So anyway, I want to say it was close to my graduation time, and I think right before graduation, my dad was like, he called me in his room. He was like, hey, Bossy, come here. Now, when he called me, I'm thinking either he wanted me to make him something to eat, clean up something, get one of my brothers, do something like that. He was like, Bossy, come here. And I'm like, okay. So when I went in there, he said, let me see your arm. So then my heart started beating so fast. He was like, let me see your arm. So mind you, I got the tattoo. It's on my right arm. So the first thing I did was I lifted up my arm like this, which was my left. And I went like this. And he was like, raise your sleeve up. So I raised it up, and mind y'all, I didn't have these tattoos. I raised it up, and he was like, okay, let me see your other arm. And I'm like, daddy, why? What's wrong? Because I'm like, daddy, why? What do you need to see my arm for? He was like, let me see your arm. So then I went like this with this arm, and he was like, now raise the sleeve up. Now, me trying to be slick, I went like this when I raised the sleeve up. And I stopped right here, and I'm like, what, daddy, what? And he was like, move your hand. And I'm like, daddy, what? I don't have nothing. What's wrong? What's wrong? What are you looking for? And he yanked my hand and moved my arm. And he was like, God damn it, Bossy. Why in the hell do you got that tattoo on your arm? He was like, what the hell is your problem? You know better. Why would you do that to your body? I'm thinking, says the man that has an earring in each one of his earlobes. And I'm like, daddy, I just went and did it on senior skip day, me and my friends, and I said the place was really clean, it wasn't dirty, it was neat, the needles was sterilized, they was brand new, everything was nice and clean. He was like, you don't do that to your body, you don't mutilate your body like that. And again, I'm looking at his damn ears, and you're a man. So I'm like, daddy, I only got this and it's not that big. And he gonna try to be funny too, either unless he just wasn't reading it right, because my E did kind of look like a C, just a little bit. But he's like, why would you get basic on you? And I was like, daddy, it says Bossy, my nickname. And he was like, why are you trying to hide? Why are you trying to sneak? You and your stupid ass friends going out getting tattoos and this and that. And I don't know if he knew that I skipped school on senior skip day, but yeah, I end up getting on punishment. And I'm thinking, how are you gonna put me on punishment? And I graduate from high school in like another week or so. And mind y'all, by then too, I found out I was pregnant. I was newly pregnant, but I found out I was pregnant. But I'm like, how's he gonna like put me on punishment? I'm about to graduate high school. Like me, I'm thinking I'm grown. Like I should be able to get a tattoo, knowing damn well I was scared of my daddy. But yeah, y'all, that was the time that I caught myself being grown, thinking I was gonna go get a tattoo. It was senior skip day. I was trying to be a rebel. But you know, after that, it opened my horizons for more tattoos, because I have 8 or 9. I plan on getting maybe 1 or 2 more. After that, I'm done, because I have all my kids' names on me except my youngest baby boy. So I'm gonna get his name just to, hey, so he won't feel left out. But yeah, y'all, word to the wise. If you know you ain't got no business doing nothing and you think you being slick, 9 times out of 10, you gonna get busted. I knew for a fact I wouldn't have had permission to get no tattoo, especially because I was still living under my dad's roof and he didn't play them games. And like, while I'm trying to be slick, something, hey, like my daddy said, don't nothing last but right. So you might not think you getting caught, but some way, somehow, you gonna get busted. So try to do the right thing. At least ask your parents first before you do something you ain't got no business doing. And even if he hadn't found out, who knows? My arm could have got infected. I could have got some kind of gangrene or something on my body from just doing that. But you guys, I hope you enjoyed this little short story time video. And please make sure to comment, rate, and subscribe. And I will see you guys in my next video. Bye, loves.
One of them ones.